What exactly are the chemicals in our environment that can negatively impact your hormonal health, and more specifically, your testosterone levels? These chemicals are collectively known as endocrine disruptors. All plastics contain them to some degree because of how they're manufactured, and they're also found in many commonly used household items such as cleaning, health, and beauty products. These chemicals imitate certain hormones and can throw off the balance of hormone production if they enter the body. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the most common endocrine disruptors that destroy testosterone and give you tons of tips on how to purge some of them out of your life. If you're new here, my name's Ben Richardson. I'm a personal trainer, a certified nutrition coach, and a chemical engineer. For years, I suffered from low testosterone levels from being fat, lazy, and overweight. And it wasn't until I went through a pretty nasty breakup in college that I finally started to get a grip on my life. So I'm here to share what I've learned with other men so that they can improve their health and increase testosterone naturally, just like I did. And I do post videos like this one every single week, so make sure you subscribe so that you're not missing out. Okay, so the good news is that you don't have to drastically change your routine to follow this endocrine disruptors purge protocol. You just need to make a few adjustments to how you do things that you already do. But you want to make sure you do all of these things collectively, so make sure you stick around until the end so that you don't miss anything. Let's dive in. So like I mentioned, endocrine disruptors closely resemble certain hormone molecules. When your hormonal system mistakes these molecules for certain hormones, it causes the body to do things like increase estrogen levels and decrease testosterone production. Endocrine disruptors can block or amplify the hormonal messages sent to and from the various biological systems in your body, and this causes hormonal imbalances. Research has even revealed a link between exposure to these chemicals and learning disabilities. Exposure to endocrine disruptors can even cause DNA damage. And the worst part is that these covert chemicals are everywhere. Their use in industry is so widespread that completely avoiding them altogether is nearly impossible. Listing every product and item that they can be found in would take a freaking encyclopedia. Or as Ted from How I Met Your Mother would say, an encyclopedia.
Oh, you think it should be pronounced encyclopedia? It's a common mistake. If you look up that squished together AE symbol in this here encyclopedia, you'll learn that it's a ligature derived from the Anglo-Saxon rune.
So I'm going to talk about the most dangerous ones and what you can do to cut back on your exposure to them. Chances are you're already being exposed to them on a daily basis, but don't worry. You'll be in good shape as soon as you start adopting some of these tactics into your routine. Hands down, the most common endocrine disruptors, which are also therefore the most dangerous, are compounds called phthalates. Phthalates are estrogen-imitating plastic softeners that can easily leach out of plastic materials. They enter your body through ingestion, inhalation, or absorption through the skin. By the way, your skin is your largest organ, and because of that, you have to take care of it because it ultimately does impact your hormonal health. Phthalates have been linked to reductions in testosterone production and sperm cell damage in men. They are found in plastic bags, plastic food packaging, plastic cooking and eating utensils, plastic tools, garden hoses, plastic shower curtains, waterproof raincoats, and manufactured hygiene products like soaps, shampoos, conditioners, deodorants, shaving creams, lotions, body sprays, and colognes. Unfortunately, this list is nowhere near complete. To combat these endocrine disruptors, ensure that you thoroughly clean your home. Phthalates can escape from plastics and become mixed in with the dust in the air, and always remove any food or drinks from plastic packaging before cooking or consuming it. Avoid plastic packaging altogether if you can. Thoroughly rinse produce with water before cooking or consuming it also. Tap water should be okay for this, but if you're overly concerned about potentially harmful chemicals in your tap water, then you can go the extra mile and use filtered water. Replace all of your plastic cooking utensils with wooden or metal ones. Get rid of those plastic or rubber-like spatulas and use wooden or metal ones instead. When you cook with those things, you're breaking down the plastic material when you use it to flip or mix the food or whatever the heck you do. You're exposing it to heat when you're cooking, and that breaks down the material into microplastics, products, which go on to permeate right into the food that you're about to eat. And the same thing is true for coated nonstick pots and pans. Most of them have some kind of plastic material like Teflon integrated into the coating, which breaks down over time after repeatedly heating them and letting them cool. Throw out your Tupperware and get some kind of metal or glass food containers. Stop storing food in plastic containers. I recommend transferring produce that comes in plastic packaging into metal or glass food containers. So for instance, if you buy meat in plastic packaging, I'd just move it into a glass or metal container when you get home from the grocery store. A little hack for you is to stop throwing any glass jars or bottles away that you buy at the store. I used to buy kombucha that came in these glass bottles, and I washed them and reused the glass to store things like orange juice and pomegranate juice, because those juices usually came in plastic jugs. Always keep mason jars if you buy salsas or some kind of sauce that comes in a glass jar. Pickle jars are also really good to keep. Heck, you can stuff ground beef in those. You don't have to spend $100 and go buy Pyrex glass or stainless steel food containers. I mean, you can if you want. I've purchased a few of them throughout the years, and they do work great. But if you're just a little creative about cutting back on food exposure to plastics, it can make a massive difference over the course of weeks, months, and even years. And guys, chime in if you have additional tips, please. Blast the comments section down there. These materials are destroying our testosterone levels. Let's brainstorm ways to cut back in them so we can all be healthy. And then another thing you can do is to search for phthalate-free products, because many companies are actually eliminating these harmful endocrine disruptors from their products, so it's worth doing the research to go find them. But always read the ingredients list of foods or hygiene products before you buy them. Even some products labeled natural can still contain endocrine disrupting chemicals. Phthalate-free products could also contain alternative chemicals that may be a little bit better than phthalates, but they're still nonetheless harmful, so always check the ingredients list. Okay, moving on to the next topic. Let me talk a little bit about taking care of your skin. When it comes to your skincare, the things that you put on your skin, like cleaning products, shampoos, shaving creams, and deodorants, can all contain lots of chemicals. Your skin is susceptible to absorbing these chemicals, which is how they enter your body, so they ultimately can impact your endocrine system. Your endocrine system now has to use energy to flush out those chemical toxins in your body, so if you'd avoided them to begin with, your endocrine system could have used that energy to upregulate healthy hormones like testosterone. So you're essentially eliminating these chemical stressors so that your body can use more energy to do healthy things instead of using them to prevent unhealthy things from doing damage. One of the most effective things that you can do is to start taking cold showers. The reason that I'm such a fan of cold showers is that if you think about it, just in terms of the temperature of the water and what that's going to do to your skin, cold showers are going to cause your skin to contract. Hot showers or even warm showers are going to cause your skin to expand. So think about what's going to happen when you put products on your skin while it's expanded versus while it's contracted. If your skin expands, the endocrine disrupting chemicals that could be in the products that you're using are going to enter your body. Whereas if you take a cold shower, your skin is going to contract and not as many of those chemicals are going to get through. This is going to reduce the amount of toxins that enter your body. So just simply taking cold showers instead of hot or warm showers, that's going to do wonders for your skin. And taking cold showers is not for the faint of heart. If taking cold showers first thing in the morning when you wake up doesn't do anything else for you, it'll at least make doing hard things much easier. Because a cold shower sucks just as much one morning as it does the next, so getting into this habit is going to reinforce your ability to suck it up, be a man, and do hard things. Testosterone production is also much more efficient at lower temperatures. That's actually why your balls hang in a sack outside of your body, so that your balls can stay nice and cool, so that all the good and wonderful things that happen in there can take place efficiently. Okay, real quick, if you're finding this information helpful, make sure you hit the like button. It helps me out, which helps other men out because they're more likely to see this. And let's be honest, the world is in need of more healthy masculine men who take care of themselves. All right, something else you can do for your skin, which is kind of the opposite of taking a cold shower, is to sit in a dry sauna to sweat out some of the toxins in your body. Because sweating is one of the ways that your body eliminates toxins in your system. I highly recommend the dry sauna instead of a wet sauna, because wet saunas obviously use water to create steam, and most water sources could have endocrine disrupting chemicals in them. So you don't want those chemicals leaching into your skin, so dry saunas are definitely a better bet here. And quick tangent about saunas, please stop drinking water out of a plastic bottle if you use the sauna. Heat causes plastic materials to break down, and guess where those microplastics are going to go if you're sitting in the sauna sipping on some water in a plastic bottle? They're going to leach into the water that you're drinking. Okay, what else? You want to use natural products on your skin? Quit using those generic soaps and shampoos, conditioners, lotions, cleansers, shaving creams, deodorants, exfoliators, whatever it is. Honestly, man, all you need is some good quality soap to wash your body with, some natural deodorant to keep yourself from smelling like crap, and some shampoo to wash your hair once or twice a week. That's it. I personally get really nerdy about the soap thing. I'm actually a big fan of just making my own soap, but you don't have to be that nerdy about it like me. I mean, like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, I'm a chemical engineer, so I can't really help myself. But you can still just go to the store and you can find good quality soaps, shampoos, and deodorants. Pay attention to the list of ingredients in the products that you're buying. Try to dwindle that list of ingredients down more. You should be able to pronounce the names of the ingredients in the product. That's a nice little rule of thumb with this. You can also use an electric razor so that you don't have to put a bunch of creams on your face to shave. That's what I do. If you do still want to use a razor, then you can use coconut oil instead of shaving cream to lubricate your skin. I always get razor burn when I shave with a razor anymore, so I just switch to using an electric razor and it doesn't bother my skin. By the way, you can also use coconut oil in your hair if you want to put some product in it. I don't use hair product. I just put coconut oil in my hair and style it. You really don't need to buy all these fancy skincare products to take care of your skin. If you just simplify your life and the products that you use, your body is going to respond well to it. Every freaking YouTuber out there is sponsored by Tiege Hanley, and they tell you that their skincare routine products are essential for taking good care of your skin, but you do not need any of that crap. Use gloves when handling plastics to limit the amount of chemicals the skin absorbs. Obviously, that's only sometimes practical, but when it comes to cleaning the house, it should be okay. Again, you really don't need to change a lot in your routine with this because you already take showers and you probably already use most of the products I mentioned. So if you're just more selective about the quality of the products that you use and lower the temperature of the water you shower in, that's going to do wonders for your skin health. Your hormonal system and your testosterone levels are going to thank you for cutting back on your exposure to endocrine disruptors. So make sure you adopt all of these tactics simultaneously for the best and the fastest results. Now, if you're interested in daily habits that you can do to increase testosterone, check out this video on 9 daily habits to boost testosterone naturally. I'll leave it on the end screen and in the description so you can check it out when you're done watching this one. If you need help getting your lifestyle habits in check to become the most energetic, confident, masculine version of yourself by improving your male hormone output, I do offer coaching. I can help you replace all your bad habits with good ones that'll increase your testosterone levels naturally. And this should be your goal as a man, by the way, because optimizing your testosterone levels is going to unlock that raw masculine vitality that is embedded in your DNA as a man. So if that sounds like something you're interested in, click the link below in the pinned comment and fill out the quick form there. It only takes like 1 or 2 minutes, and I'll reach out to set up a quick Zoom call so we can chat about how I can help. So I hope to hear from you soon. Anyways, that's all for this video. If you liked it, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And again, if you're new here and you've made it this far, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel as well. Let me know what you thought about the video down in the comments below. I always love hearing from you guys, and it helps me make the kind of content that you guys want to see when I hear from you directly, so don't be a stranger. If you made it to the end, I do appreciate the support, and I hope you got a ton out of this video too. Good luck in all of your efforts to boost your testosterone levels naturally. Thanks for watching, everyone. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video.